You know, look, America has a history of 200 years of slavery. Mm-hmm. People aren't starting out on the same base in terms of their ability to succeed. And so we have got to recognize that and give people a lift up.
So you are for some type of...
Yes, I am.
Reparation. Okay.
Yes, I am.
There used to be an eccentric opinion. Suddenly lots of people seem to have it, not just Kamala Harris. Today, just today, Senator Elizabeth Warren, maybe under the influence of peyote, said that she also supports reparations. So did Julian Castro. Just 2 years ago, keep in mind, Bernie Sanders and Hillary Clinton were both asked about this and both said they opposed it. 5 years from now, we'll be tearing down statues for taking that position, but that's where we are today. Author and columnist Mark Stein has been following this and joins us tonight. Things like seems like things are moving kind of fast, Mark.
Yeah, they are. And this is disturbing if reparations is becoming a mainstream position. It's particularly absurd, I think, for Elizabeth Warren to be in favor of that. This is someone who, in a sense, has benefited from a fake appropriation of racial grievance. As you know, the business about her being 1,024th Native American, presumably, and yet presenting herself as Harvard Law School's first woman of color. That's what happens when you actually get into this sort of neo-apartheid of racial classification. And I find it particularly absurd. I mean, when Kamala Harris says people are not starting from the same point, slavery was abolished a century and a half ago. Nobody alive today has a grandparent who was a slave. And in that sense, I think you reach a point where, you know, you need to move on. I mean, the reparations thing eventually, as the decades go by, becomes ridiculous. I'm Canadian. I think you guys should give us reparations, because if you hadn't had the revolution, we'd have the whole continent would now be Canada. And if you were going to steal our land from us and drive the loyalists out, Tucker, you could at least have divided the continent east-west so that we Canadians weren't holed up in the cold bit.
Which half would you take?
Well, exactly. I think I'd have the half without the Californian presidential candidates in it.
I think that's right.
On balance, or maybe the bit in the middle, and you guys could have the two coasts. But the point here is, this is nothing real. This is nothing real to the lived experience of people of all kinds of identities today. And certainly not to Kamala Harris has a Jamaican father and an Indian mother. And I don't know whether it's the identity politics, as her father was suggesting earlier today. I don't know whether it's this whole identity politics obsession that means she has to feel she has to genuflect to this, because her own experience is, in fact, entirely apart from the
exactly.
African American slave
it's
experience.
It's also bad, though. It's really divisive.
Mm.
Mark Stein,
no,
great to
is,
see you. Thank you
really
for that.
Divisive.
It is.
Thanks a lot, Tucker.
See ya. Time now for final exam. Two contestants create chaos.